Hello, it's Polish Paul VR, welcome to the channel, and let's do freshest PSVR news in the village. Check out the new microphone. It's so small, yet so powerful, just like professional people on professional television. But even better, because on this channel we only talk in PlayStation VR. And let's just do it, let's jump into the news. But before I jump there, actually let me remind you, the merch is here. Many of you have been asking for a long time, finally I get around it and done it. So check out the store, also the link is in the description, but you can go to the channel page and just go to the store. Yes, there is some hoodies, there is a pink hoodie, the merch is called Only Gamer in the Village with little PlayStation VR pattern around. I hope you like it, let me know what you think to this merch. And of course, make sure if you buy one, if you're on Twitter, do a photo with my merch, tag me in so I can have a look and also retweet it, and just, I think it's gonna be cool to see anyway. But let's do it, let's talk about the news, and today we're gonna start from Star Wars Squadrons and from the little confusion that's been going on since the game got announced. And this confusion, of course, is all about HOTAS support. Nobody knows what's going on until today, so what's been happening in the gaming saying it's got HOTAS, but people didn't know if it's PC, if it's PS4 as well, it sounded like both, but the developer clarified it all and said that as of now, Star Wars Squadrons only supports HOTAS on the PC. Now, this is quite a bad situation, especially if you own PlayStation VR, because you want to play this game with HOTAS as well, I'm assuming. What I'm thinking what's gonna happen is, before the release of the game, they're gonna add HOTAS support on PS4. It's not that hard to do, even indie games do it, like your Ultra Wings and Space, which is a team of two people working on this game. So it can be done, and I think it would be big oversight on the Electronic Arts side to not include HOTAS on PlayStation 4, especially if PC players will be able to use it. And my best guess is, listen, do not worry about it. I'm sure that before Star Wars Squadrons hits PlayStation 4 and PlayStation VR, the HOTAS will be already included. Of course, HOTAS stands for Hands on Throttle and Stick, which is of course your flight stick. And that is the best way to play games like that. If you played End Space and if you played Eve Valkyrie, you know how much better those games are with the flight stick. When it comes to PlayStation 4 and PlayStation VR, there is not that many options when it comes to flight sticks anyway. There is just few companies making them, but the one under $100 is of course Thrustmaster, and this flight stick does its job perfectly. So I say, if you don't have one, stay tuned to the channel, and as soon as Electronic Arts will announce HOTAS for PS4, which I'm assuming it will happen before the release, then I pass it on and then you can get yourself one. Bit of a boomer, because in past I was sure it's gonna be for both PC and PS4, now the developers clarified that. But also there was a big response from the PlayStation community itself, and everyone been saying pretty much like, you have to be kidding me, we want HOTAS support on PlayStation 4 as well. And as you know, the developers always read the comments, always want to give players what they want. So like I said, I'm pretty sure before we get Star Wars Squadron on PlayStation 4 and PSVR, the HOTAS will be there from day one. I don't think we even gonna have to wait for the patch. I think this is maybe a bit of miscommunication when the developer said yes, as of now it only supports PC, but as we know, the game not releasing till 3rd of October, so still a bit of wait. And like I said, it's not even that hard to implement, so I'm assuming it will happen on PlayStation 4. Okay, anyway, let's move on to the another story, and now I would like to talk about Sniper Elite VR. Many of you asking me about this game, I asking myself about this game, always trying to find some information about it. Sadly, there's nothing there. Only thing what we can go by is that rumor that the game gonna release towards the end of the year. But saying that, there might be no information about the actual game. There is some information about the studio, what's making the game, which is just Adwater. And what they're doing, they advertising new job listings. There's tons of them, they got few projects going. But one of those jobs listings is very interesting, because it wants a programmer to work on their future and current VR projects. And by projects, that indicates that they might have another VR game in works, but also it indicates they might need somebody to help them with Sniper Elite VR as well, I don't know. But what's happening with the studio at the moment, they're in full swing on making this game. as we know, there is a playable version they've been demoing in. I think they wanted to demo Sniper Elite VR this year as well, but of course, because of the pandemic, they couldn't do so. But nevertheless, there is that demo out there, what people already played and they really enjoyed it. And also with this studio, with those job listings, it seems like they're gonna stick to VR for longer than just one game. And also it shows that they working full on Sniper Elite VR. Regarding Sniper Elite VR, of course, on PlayStation VR, it will support aim controller, but you don't have to play with aim. If you don't have one, you can use DualShock or Move controllers. The game will have smooth locomotion, but also you can choose the teleportation. They've done everything pretty much very right. They must have looked to what VR players want, and they must have come to conclusion and say, yes, what people want is tons of options in VR, because different people play VR differently, and that's what they do. For me, the best thing about it is that it's supporting aim controller. That's gonna be pretty awesome. So the latest on this game is studio basically recruiting for new programmers for VR games, but also the rumor is that this game gonna be coming towards the end of this year. My best guess is gonna be like somewhere November time, but that's just guessing. I'm not 100% sure, but nevertheless, I'm super extremely hyped for Sniper Elite VR, probably one of the better upcoming PlayStation VR games. Anyway, moving on, I want to talk a bit about Superhot. As you know, they announced lately, maybe you don't know, so I just gonna tell you now, they announced brand new free expansion for Superhot called Mind Control Delete. But this expansion, don't get it confused with Superhot VR, it's not, it's for the flat version. And from the comments what I read, there was a lot of disappointed people, because many of VR owners and many people, you know, not only on PlayStation VR but PC VR as well, they want more Superhot VR. So this Mind Control Delete, even though it's nice for the flat players, VR players are not happy about it. PC players know that this thing existed because it's been out of on early access for a while. But listen, let me tell you this, if you want more Superhot VR, do not worry, I'm sure you're gonna get some as well. Keep in mind, Superhot VR earned them way more money than the actual Superhot game. Superhot VR surpassed it massively. It's one of the best-selling VR games out there on the market, on all of the headsets. I think the developers not long ago announced that they reached double platinum or made $2 million, something like that. So definitely big success story. But also, speaking about Superhot VR, couple of months ago, I posted a little, I don't know, I think it was like in my weekly PlayStation VR Super Show. We've been chatting about Superhot VR. The developer basically posted on their Twitter what they do to make the programming in VR easier for them. So they made the mod for Oculus that it lets just lift it out of the way, so they can get in and out of VR very fast. But this post indicated that they do work on VR content. So just to keep you reassured, Superhot VR probably will get some more content, or we might see brand new Superhot VR game. So as of now, don't be bummed that flat gamers getting extra expansion for Superhot, because we gonna get something regarding Superhot VR in the future as well. Probably just takes this bit longer to make. Okay, next story I want to talk about is Zenith, this upcoming MMORPG. So the story of this game basically is the developer announced it and then they went to Kickstarter. People liked the announcement so much that they give them tons and tons of money. And now the game surpassed all the goals, or the extra stretch goals as well. So the developers making it. Lately, they posted yet another update, and I want to say from myself and also as somebody who owns PlayStation VR, when they've been posting previous updates, I already said it's strange that they never comment on PlayStation VR. And in this latest update, they actually said that they've done pre-alpha and they are able to better optimize this game for the Oculus, Steam and Quest, and nothing regarding PSVR. I don't think they even done alpha for PlayStation VR. And for me, as you know, one of PSVR owners, I know how many PlayStation VR owners give them money through the Kickstarter for the PlayStation VR version. Keep in mind, they still maintain that PSVR version is coming, but what I do not like what they're doing is that they're not giving any PlayStation VR updates about the game. I mean, if you're taking people money, it's nice, you know, that you're doing updates for PC players, but you could actually reassure and let PlayStation VR owners know what's happening with the game as well. Because as we know from the experience, the making the game on PC and then releasing it on PlayStation VR, it can be a bit of a struggle, and also, you know, you have to have your PSVR in mind while developing the game for multi-platform VR. This is something what Arizona Sunshine developers been saying. That was their mistake because they released the game on PC first without thinking on PSVR, and then they've had problems with optimization and actual PSVR release. So I hope that in the future, with the next update, finally Zenith developers gonna let us know, as PlayStation VR owners, what is the state of the PSVR port. And that would be nice because, like I said, people gave them money. Okay, anyway, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.